Hey, I have a quick question for you.
Yep.
Where is the best place, do you think, to place a UV light on a system? Would it be above the coil, below the coil? The reason I asked, we got a question about this on our YouTube channel the other day, and I thought it would be a really good thing to ask.
Yeah, no, it's a good question. It really kind of depends on what the goal is. There's a couple, the two ductwork sections of ductwork that you have going in and out of your comfort system in your home is the return duct. So the duct, usually on a gas furnace, comes down the side of it and into the bottom. And then the supply duct that comes up through the top of it and goes up to your home to deliver the conditioned air throughout. Well, statistically speaking, putting the UV light on the return duct, they say, has a higher kill rate for bacteria, germs, viruses, because of the consistent, roughly 70 degree air temperature in that duct. So from a germ, bacteria, virus perspective, it will kill more when it's in that kind of climate. But it's not killing surface stuff, germs, bacteria, virus. It's just airborne stuff that's blowing across these bulbs. On the supply duct, right before the ductwork, is a cold, damp coil known as the evaporator coil in your air conditioning system. And that coil, it's dark, damp, swampy environment. That coil gets really cold and there's no sunlight. And so putting it above that coil can be great for fighting bacterial growth on the fins of that coil and on the tubes of that coil all summer long. Really, the light shines down on it typically all year, but especially in the summer when that coil is cold from the air conditioning system.
I'm assuming you have one in your house.
I do. I have a couple of them.
Oh, okay. I was going to ask just where do you place yours at your house personally?
My UV lights are both on my return duct because not that it wouldn't benefit from above the evaporator coil, but for me, it was driven by allergies, runny noses, all the stuff the kids bring home. The daycares and stuff like that. And in order to just kill airborne stuff and just blow air across those bulbs all the time and just cleanse the air that way, it had more to do with the air more than it had to do with surfaces.
If somebody only wanted it on the coil, where's the best location there?
Yeah, you definitely want to put a UV light above the coil, not under it. Depending on the application, but that coil does get cold and damp. If something goes wrong with it, water can start draining down through it. And if it gets on that UV light bulb, that could go badly. You really want it above it. And the amount of light produced by those ultraviolet systems are enough to penetrate every inch of those fins of that coil and sterilize that coil year round. So putting it above it is really the preferred place.
All right, thanks very
Yeah,
much.
you're
All
welcome.
right.